क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, व्हाट इज न्यूक्लियर फिजिक्स? आंसर इज द ब्रांच ऑफ फिजिक्स विच डील्स विद द एटॉमिक न्यूक्लियस एंड द प्रॉपर्टीज एसोसिएटेड विद इट इज कॉल्ड न्यूक्लियर फिजिक्स। क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, व्हाट इज एंटी पार्टिकल? आंसर इज एवरी पार्टिकल हैज इट्स एंटी पार्टिकल विच हैज सेम मास एंड सेम चार्ज बट इट्स साइन इज डिफरेंट। That shows if the original particle is positive, then its antiparticle must be negative. Question number 3 is, what are isobars? Answer is, isobars are the nuclei of the same element which have the same mass number but different atomic number. Isko isotope se likhna tha, uski zyada definition. Question number 4 is, what are isomers? Answer is isomers are the nuclei of the same element which have the same atomic number and same mass number. Question number 5 is, does nucleus produce magnetic moment? Answer is yes. Nucleus also produces magnetic moment because of the orbital and spin motion of nucleons. But nuclear magnetic moment is weak enough to be neglected. Question number 6 is, tell me how nuclear force is produced inside the nucleus. Answer is, nuclear force is produced inside the nucleus because of rapid and continuous exchange of pions among nucleons. This is how nuclear force is produced inside the nucleus. Question number 7 is, what are magic numbers? ये बहुत important question है, बहुत बार interview पूछा जाता है. Answer is, मैजिक नंबर्स आर 2, 8, 20, 28, 50, 82 and 126. इट टेल्स अस अनदर स्टोरी, इट टेल्स अस व्हाई सर्टेन न्यूक्लियाई आर मोर स्टेबल देन द अदर न्यूक्लियाई। इफ द नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स और न्यूट्रॉन्स इनसाइड द न्यूक्लियस बिकम्स इक्वल टू द वन ऑफ द मैजिक नंबर्स देन सच न्यूक्लियस इज मोर स्टेबल देन द रेस्ट ऑफ द न्यूक्लियाई। ठीक है, गुड। Question number 8 is, what is nuclear spin? Answer is, it is the total angular momentum produced by the orbital and spin motion of nucleons. Question number 9 is, what are neutrons? Why are neutrons more in heavy nucleus? Answer is, the actual reason is to compensate the high electrostatic repulsion caused by the protons. Question number 10 is, does atomic nucleus obey Fermi-Dirac statistics or Bose-Einstein statistics? Answer is both. If the nucleus contains even number of nucleons, then their spin will become full integral and the nucleus is bound to obey Bose-Einstein statistics. क्योंकि देखो ये जो protons और neutrons होते हैं nucleus के अंदर, ये दोनों ही fermion हैं। अगर तो ये positive क्या कहते हैं इवन होंगे तो लाजमी सी बात है इंटेग्रल स्पिन ही बनेगी, या वन होगा या टू या जीरो, कभी हाफ नहीं बन सकती, इसलिए ये ओबे करेंगे बोसोन आइंस्टाइन स्टैटिस्टिक्स को। सिमिलरली इफ द न्यूक्लियस विद ओवर नंबर ऑफ न्यूक्लियॉन्स, ठीक है, न्यूक्लियस विद ओवर नंबर ऑफ न्यूक्लियॉन्स हैव हाफ इंटेग्रल स्पिन। देखो सीधी सी बात है, अगर तीन होंगे पाँच होंगे तो लाजमी सी बात है उसमें जो स्पिन होगी टोटल हाफ हाफ ऐड करोगे तो हाफ ही आएगी, कभी फुल नहीं बनेगी। सो आंसर है, Similarly, nucleus with odd number of nucleons have half integral spin. So the nucleus is bound to obey Fermi-Dirac statistics. Question number 1. What is beta decay? Answer is, the emission of electron or positron from the unstable nucleus is called beta decay. Question number 2 is, tell me how an electron can be emitted from the nucleus in beta decay, because we know nucleus doesn't have any electron. Answer is, the reason is that the neutron is converted into proton, then negative pion is also emitted. That negative pion appears as electron outside the nucleus. This is how an electron emits in beta decay. Question number 3 is there any difference between the spectrum of alpha and beta rays? Answer is yes, the spectrum produced by alpha ray is discrete, whereas spectrum produced by beta ray is continuous. Question number 4 is which phenomena is responsible for alpha decay? Answer is tunneling phenomena is responsible for alpha decay. Question number 5 is what is radioactivity? Answer is the spontaneous emission of certain radiations from the unstable nucleus is called radioactivity. These radiations are alpha, beta and gamma. Question number 6 is what is half-life? Answer is it is the time in which half of the atoms of the radioactive element decay. Question number 7 is what is neutrino hypothesis in beta decay? Answer is neutrino is also emitted in the beta decay in order to conserve the angular momentum. Question number 8 is what is the difference between gamma rays and X-rays? Answer is both are electromagnetic radiation. The difference is that X-rays are emitted from the outside of the nucleus, whereas gamma rays are emitted from the inside of the nucleus. और बार बार क्वेश्चन ये आते हैं कि किसकी एनर्जी ज़्यादा होती है. याद रखना जो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स जो हैं आउटसाइड द न्यूक्लियस, इनमें जो एनर्जी लेवल्स का डिफरेंस है ना वो है इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट में होता है. जो न्यूक्लियस के शेल्स होते हैं ना उसमें जो डिफरेंस होता है वो होता है मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. तो जो गैमा रेज का फोटोन जो है ना इससे ज़्यादा होता है, क्योंकि जो वहाँ से जो निकलता है फोटोन जिस शेल से निकलता है उनमें जो डिफरेंस है वो मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट है, इसलिए गैमा रेज का जो फोटोन है वो ज़्यादा नतीजा होता है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 इज व्हाट इज डिके कॉन्स्टेंट? आंसर इज नंबर ऑफ एटम्स डिके पर यूनिट टाइम इज कॉल्ड डिके कॉन्स्टेंट. इतनी डेफिनेशन है, तीसरा को बताने के लिए है पर यूनिट टाइम मीन्स इन वन सेकेंड. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 इज व्हाट इज गैमा डिके? आंसर इज व्हेन एन एक्साइटेड न्यूक्लियस कम्स बैक टू द ग्राउंड स्टेट इट एमिट्स अ फोटोन कॉल्ड गैमा रेडिएशन. दिस इज हाउ गैमा डिके इज कैरिड आउट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 व्हाट इज लिक्विड रॉक मॉडल? आंसर इज अकॉर्डिंग टू लिक्विड रॉक मॉडल अ न्यूक्लियस इज सपोज्ड टू बी लाइक अ लिक्विड रॉक बिकॉज़ देयर आर सो मेनी सिमिलैरिटीज फाउंड इन बोथ ऑफ देम. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 इज व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन एंडोथर्मिक एंड एक्सोथर्मिक न्यूक्लियर रिएक्शन? आंसर इज in endothermic reaction energy is absorbed whereas in exothermic reaction energy is released. Question number 3 is what are thermal neutrons? Answer is thermal neutrons are slow moving neutrons having energy equal to 0.025 electron volt at room temperature. These neutrons are used in fission reaction. Question number 4 is what is fission process? A fission reaction also. It is a nuclear reaction in which a heavy nucleus is split into two lighter nuclei having almost equal size, and in that process a huge amount of energy is released. This process is called nuclear fission. Question number 5 is can you tell us in which process more energy is released, either in nuclear fission or in nuclear fission? Ye kai baar solve kiya jata hai. Answer is in nuclear fission more energy is released. Question number 6 is where is nuclear fission phenomenon carried out? ye kai baar dafa swal puchha. Answer is nuclear fission phenomena is carried out in the sun, star and in hydrogen bomb. Question number 7 is how many isotopes does uranium atom have? ye bhi kai baar swal pucha gaya hai. Answer is there are two isotopes. Uranium atom has two isotopes. Question number 8 is which uranium isotope is used in fission process? It is an important question. Answer is
Uranium-235 is the only isotope that is used in nuclear fission process. Question number 9 is, what are prompt neutrons? Answer is, those neutrons which are emitted very swiftly within 10 raised to the power minus 14 seconds in nuclear fission reaction are called prompt neutrons. Last question of this video is, why moderators are used in nuclear reactors? Answer is, moderators are used to slow down the fast moving neutrons so that they can be used for further fission reaction. Question number 1. What is the difference between elementary and composite particles? Answer is, elementary particles are those particles that are not composed of other particles such as electrons, and whereas the composite particles are composed of other elementary particles called quarks. Its examples are protons and neutrons. Question number 2 is, what is the difference between leptons and hadrons? Answer is, leptons are elementary particles, whereas hadrons are not elementary particles. Rather, they are composed of other elementary particles called quarks. Question number 3 is, what is the difference between mesons and baryons? Answer is, both are hadrons, but the difference is that baryons consist of 3 quarks, whereas mesons consist of 2 quarks. Examples have protons and neutrons are baryons, whereas pion is meson. Question number 4 is, can you tell us whether hadrons are fermions or bosons? Answer is, hadrons can be either fermions or bosons. If hadron consists of 2 quarks, then they become bosons. On the other hand, if hadron consists of 3 quarks, then they become fermions. Question number 5 is, what are the basic differences between fermions and bosons? Ye bahut hi important question. Answer is, fermions are those particles which have half integral spin, whereas bosons are those particles which have full integral spin. Second difference is, fermions obey Fermi-Dirac statistics, whereas bosons obey Bose-Einstein statistics. Third difference, fermions obey Pauli-Exclusion principle, whereas bosons don't obey Pauli-Exclusion principle. Examples have, fermions ke examples hain electron, proton and neutron, and bosons examples have gravitons, photons and phonons. Moving on to question number 6, what is the strongest force among the 4 fundamental forces? Answer is, strong nuclear force is the strongest fundamental force. Question number 7 is, ye bahut important question hai, kai jagah pucha gaya hai, do you know how actually the strong nuclear force is produced? Answer is, strong nuclear force is actually produced by the exchange of gluons among quarks. Question number 8 is, ये भी पूछा जाता है आपको, ये भी अच्छा बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है, तो हमको पता होना चाहिए कि न्यूक्लियर फोर्स कैसे प्रोड्यूस होती है. हाउ वीक न्यूक्लियर फोर्स इज प्रोड्यूस? आंसर इज, वीक न्यूक्लियर फोर्स इज प्रोड्यूस बाय द एक्सचेंज ऑफ डब्ल्यू जेड पार्टिकल अमंग क्वार्क्स एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. ठीक है ना, बाद को पूछ लेता है न्यूक्लियर फोर्स क्या लेता है, बाद को पता है इंट्रैक्शन, दोनों में से पूछ सकते हैं. ठीक है, ये भी कह सकते हैं वीक न्यूक्लियर इंट्रैक्शन भी इसको कहते हैं, और इसको वीक न्यूक्लियर फोर्स भी कहते हैं. इसी तरह strong nuclear interaction or strong nuclear force. Okay. Question number 9 is, what is graviton? Answer is, quantum of gravitational force is called graviton. Question number 10 is, which two forces did Abdul Salam and his partners combine? Answer is, they combined electromagnetic and weak nuclear force. Question number 11 is, what are quarks? Answer is, quarks are the basic building block of letters. All hadrons are composed of quarks. Question number 12 is, do quarks have color? Most important question है. Answer is, yeah, quarks have three colors, red, green and blue. Question number 13 is, if quarks have color, then why hadrons have no color? ये भी बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है, ये पता होना चाहिए. आंसर इज, although hadrons are composed of colored quarks, yet they are colorless because quarks are combined in such a way that their colors are disappeared in the formation of hadrons. Question number 14 is, what is Stendhal model? ये भी बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है. आंसर इज, Stendhal model combines the electro weak and strong nuclear interaction and it is used to describe the entire structure of matter because it includes all leptons and the quarks. Question number 15 is, what is CERN? Answer is, CERN is the laboratory in Geneva where WZ particles were experimentally observed and these particles are responsible for weak nuclear interaction. Question number 16 is, which particle accelerator produces the highest energetic particle? Answer is, proton synchrotron is the particle accelerator that produces the most energetic particle. Question number 17 is, do you know what basic principles are used in radiation detector? Answer is, there are three kinds of principles used in radiation detectors. तीन कौन से हैं? Ionization, fluorescence and photographic effect. Question number 18 is, what is scintillation? कई बार हम पूछ लेते हैं. Answer is, when incident radiation strike with the fluorescent material, it emits flashes of light called scintillation. Question number 19, what is quenching? कई बार हम पूछ लेते हैं. Answer is, quenching is the process to eliminate the unwanted positive ions around the wire. Question number 20 and the last question of quantum mechanics is p-n junction forward bias or reverse bias in semiconductor detector? ठीक है ना, semiconductor detector में जो p-n junction होता है उसको हम forward bias लगाते हैं, reverse bias? Answer is, semiconductor detector work when p-n junction is reverse biased.